Hello and welcome to News of the Hour on youtube.com/NDTV. I'm Ankita Mukherjee. The big story we're looking at today is the controversial deportation of a British Labour Party MP, Debbie Abrahams, from Delhi. Now, Debbie Abrahams arrived in India yesterday, that's Monday, the 17th of February. She was coming in from Dubai on an Emirates flight. She says that the visa officer, the immigration officer at Delhi Airport, looked at her visa and she says, I presented myself at the immigration desk with my documents, including my e-visa. I had my photograph taken and then the official looked at his screen and started shaking his head. Then he told me that my visa was rejected. He took my passport, disappeared for about 10 minutes. When he came back, he was very rude and aggressive, shouting at me to come with him. I told him not to speak like that to me. I was then taken to a cordoned off area marked as a deportee cell. He then ordered me to sit down. I refused. I didn't know what they might do or where else they may take me, so I wanted people to see me. Now, then she rang a relative that she was supposed to stay with, and he called the British High Commission, who then gave her some consular help. Now, Debbie Abrahams is saying that I am prepared to let the fact that I've been treated like a criminal go, but I hope India will let me visit my friends and family. Now, a day after all of this happened, Indian government sources are in fact saying that her visa, her e-business visa, was cancelled before she travelled to India, and she was informed about this on account of quote-unquote activities which went against India's national interests. So what are we talking about? Well, for that we need to rewind to know a little more about who Debbie Abrahams is. Now, yes, she is a Labour Party MP in the United Kingdom, but she's also the chairman of the All Party UK Parliamentary Group on Kashmir. And in fact, right after the abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir, Debbie Abrahams had written a series of letters. She had written to the UK Foreign Secretary saying that the parliamentary group, Britain's parliamentary group on Kashmir, was very concerned about what was happening in Kashmir. She was also very critical of those developments in a letter that she wrote to India's High Commissioner, saying that the trust of the people of Jammu and Kashmir had been broken. Now, on Monday, as we know, she arrived in Delhi at 8:50 a.m. She was told by her immigration authorities that her visa was no longer valid. Now, it seems that they had already intimated her on Monday, the day before she traveled, that her visa had been cancelled. However, Debbie Abrahams has answered no questions on whether she received any kind of communication from the government of India or not. And in fact, she has been maintaining that very disappointing that a friend can't respectfully criticize another friend. Isn't this the sign of a healthy democracy? So a series of tweets from Debbie Abrahams, which has linked her comments on Kashmir with the visa action against her, the fact that her e-business visa was cancelled. She has also posted a picture of this e-visa that she was issued by Indian authorities. And if you look at that closely, it says date of issue 7th October 2019, date of expiry 5th October 2020. So she is making the point that her e-visa was very much valid when she came in to India. Well, government sources are saying at this point that not only was this a business visa, whereas Debbie Abrahams wanted to travel to meet family and friends, so therefore this visa was not correct for the purpose of her visit, but also that she had been informed in advance that her visa had been rejected, and the reason given for that was activities that went against India's national interests. Now, the MP has been vocal and emphatic in her criticism of Article 370 and its aftermath, with unprecedented security and communications restrictions in Jammu and Kashmir. Remember, there's been an internet blockade, one of the longest in any democracy anywhere in the world. And even now, the citizens of Kashmir are facing a great deal of restrictions, even though internet has been partially restored. India has taken several groups of foreign diplomats now to Kashmir, in two separate visits organized in the last 6 months, but access still remains very restricted, whether it is politicians belonging to this country, and in fact foreign journalists haven't been given permissions at all to go there. But let's take a look at what else is happening on Twitter right now. So Debbie Abrahams there, you see it, you know, not only posting a picture of her e-visa, as you can see, and saying that this was certainly not cancelled or it was valid when she came in. But she says, again, for clarity, I am pro-human rights and social justice. I always speak up for people who are not afforded these rights, including Kashmiris on both sides of the line of control. And that's an important statement there. She's also retweeted someone who has said, Indian High Commission UK statement on Debbie Abrahams' mission has confirmed from Indian immigration authorities that she did not hold a valid visa. Further, there is no provision for a visa on arrival for UK nationals. So it seems Debbie Abraham also asked for a visa on arrival when she was told that her visa had been rejected already or cancelled. And she was told that that couldn't be possible. And so she was deported right back to Dubai where she had come from. So Debbie Abraham's post this and saying, once again, the key questions are, why was it revoked? And when? So she is in fact denying that effectively that she had any kind of intimation from Indian authorities about her visa revocation. And then in just an hour or so earlier, she has said the UN Convention on Human Rights demands that the international community challenge states who are failing to protect the human rights of their citizens. Please read the UN report on human rights abuses in Indian administered Kashmir and Pakistan administered Kashmir. So Debbie Abraham's continuing to make this very deeply political and saying that there is obviously a reason for her visa being cancelled. Now, interestingly, Congress leader Abhishek Manu Singhvi has spoken up and has tweeted also and says the deportation of Debbie Abrahams by India was indeed necessary, as she is not just an MP but a Pakistan proxy known for her clasp with the Pakistan government and the ISI. Every attempt that tries to attack India's sovereignty must be thwarted. So very interesting that a Congress leader also now speaking out about this, raising questions about Debbie Abraham's intentions and saying that an attack on India's sovereignty must in fact be questioned. Now, as far as the rules go, the granting, the revocation or the rejection of a visa is the sovereign right of any country, is what Indian government sources are saying at this point. And they're saying that whatever has happened with Debbie Abraham is nothing out of the ordinary. Well, this is one controversy we are going to keeping track of and continue to get you the latest on this. For the moment, thanks for watching. youtube.com/NDTV, and tune in again for all the latest headlines of the day.